Good morning. My name is Ryan.
My name's Ryan.
Together we're Ryan Square.
What's cooking?
So, my name is Ryan Duncan. I'm a senior at Sue Mercator High School, and I attend Sue Mechanical Engineering.
My name is Ryan Danaher, and I'm also a senior at Stephen Care High School, and I'm pursuing civil engineering in college.
So today we are presenting to you the Easy Strain, the revolutionary new sock pot. The Easy Strain combines a regular sock pot and colander into one to make cooking easier and save storage space in your kitchen. For the purpose of saving time, we are actually not going to boil water, as that takes a little too much time for the allotted time space that we have.
So as you can see, you can add as much new as you want and boil the water, and once you turn our user-friendly handle to the left, the water in the pipe on the bottom raises up to release watertight seal, and the water drains out the bottom. Once all the water is out of the bottom, you can tighten it back up. The water starts draining, and you have your noodles left in the column.
So for our problem, we wanted to attempt to solve a common problem in the kitchen, which is having too many utensils. You don't have to go very far to hear people complaining about how they wish they had more space in their kitchen, as too many utensils are taking up that space. So on October 20th, we administered a survey with 215 responses, and 56% of those people said that storing utensils in their kitchen is a problem, and 76% of those people said that having a multi-kitchen utensil is a good idea.
Why we chose this problem, you may ask? Well, personally, I have a stay-at-home mom, and she cooks meals in the kitchen 5 or more nights a week. And I know firsthand that we have pots, pans, you name it, we got it, cluttered all over the cabinets, all over the kitchen and the sink. And using them, cleaning them, and storing them can be a major problem in our kitchen.
So we wanted to research other products that attempted to solve this problem as well. The first product we came about is a cutting board and colander in one. So you can cut up your food on the cutting board and then slide it right into the colander.
Another product that we researched that attempts to solve this problem is a multi-purpose kitchen knife, which combines the aspects of grating, zesting, and cutting all in one.
So you're probably asking, why Easy Strain? Well, compared to other products, the Easy Strain does two things in one product. You can cook your noodles or anything else that needs to be boiled, and also drain it with one tool.
So the cost of production for the Easy Strain stock pot was approximately $40. So theoretically, if we were to market this in the stores, we would sell this for $60, $59.99. So for every 100 pots sold, it's a $2,000 profit.
And other sock pots can cost upwards of $100 to even $150. The Easy Strain is only $60, so you're getting twice as much for one product at a much cheaper cost. So for our target market, according to foodsurvey.com, 72% of Americans say they cook 4 or more times a week. That comes out to be over 230 million Americans cooking 4 or more times a week, and over 930 million meals cooked every week. This shows that the Easy Strain has millions of people that it can help cook every night.
So materials used to construct the Easy Strain. We first started with a 12-quart stainless steel stock pot. Then we had rubber O-rings that are sealing the holes in the bottom of the pot to create a watertight seal. To secure these O-rings, we have heat-resistant adhesive up to 400 degrees Fahrenheit. Then we have a 6-inch diameter metal steel plate on the bottom of the pot used to apply pressure to the watertight seal. A magnet piece of metal that we use to bend to make a user-friendly handle. And then lastly, we have the metal mesh conduit in the water flue. Construction of the Easy Strain stock pots first started with, first we obtained all the materials that I just listed. We then cut dimensional holes in the bottom of the stock pot and cut them. Once we had the holes cut in the bottom of the stock pot, we had to dimension the steel plate that was going to apply pressure to the watertight seal. So we dimensioned that to 6 inches, cut that out, and cut holes in the middle of that to line up the holes of the stock pot. Once we had the holes in the bottom of the stock pot and the bottom of the steel plate, we were able to put the screw up through the middle of the steel plate in the stock pot, thread it so that the steel plate turns perfectly on the screw. Once we had everything on the bottom figured out and the handle attached to the steel plate, which can turn right to tighten against watertight seal and left to loose against watertight seal, we then attached our metal mesh colander so that we can hold water. And whenever you want, you can boil whatever you want, the food, the peas, lima beans, pasta. You can boil, and then when you want to drink, you can turn to the left and drain all the water out.
And the result is our amazing Easy Strain. So we conducted two tests. The first test was to see how much heat the O-rings and adhesive could stand. And the second test was to see if the watertight seal would actually work. So the first test, we tested it at three levels of heat, low, medium, high. Low being approximately 200 degrees, medium being 300 degrees, and high being 400 degrees. At 200 and 300 degrees, the O-rings and adhesive showed no signs of physical change. At 400 degrees, the adhesive still stayed in place, but the O-rings did start to show signs of burning.
The second test we wanted to test was our watertight seal, obviously, because that's probably the most important part of the project. So we wanted to test the watertight seal in its open position to let the water drain out, and its closed position to hold water. So in the closed position, we kept it closed and tight, and we tested three levels of water, quarter pot, half pot, and full pot of water, and at each level there was no leakage. For the open position of the pot, we wanted to drain how fast and efficiently the water is able to drain out. So with the watertight seal closed, we added three levels of water again, quarter, half, and full, and we would loosen it, it's time how much. And for the quarter pot, it took about 3 seconds to drain, half pot took about 7 seconds to drain, and the full pot took about 4 to 15 seconds to drain. So a couple of acknowledgments we want to have, to special thanks to do this project. First, Chef Sergio. He's a chef known around the area at Cisco Food Company, and he helped us get this project going with advice.
Chef Cropper, who helped us test the heat conductivity of the pot with a natural gas stove. Mr. Clay Reister, for giving us the idea of how to make our watertight seal. And Mr. Rick Stevens, for helping us weld the pot together.
And last but not least, Ms. Lee, for our 4 years of support at Everett Engineering.
Thank you. Sorry about that.